Today's encouraging word comes from Judges chapter 17, and we'll read verse number 17. And it says, "Finally, Samson shared his secret with her. 'My hair has never been cut,' he confessed, 'for I was dedicated to God as a Nazarite from birth. If my head were shaved, my strength would leave me, and I would become as weak as anyone else.'" Amen. Samson was talking to Delilah. On three prior occasions, she had asked him what was the source of his strength, and each time he deceived her. But when she thought she had the answer, she called men in to subdue Samson, and they failed miserably. And finally, on the fourth time, Samson, as the scripture tells us, just got tired of Delilah nagging him. And so he said unto her, "My hair has never been cut, and if my strength, and if my hair is cut, my strength will be gone, and I'll be weak just as any other man." And this time when Samson fell asleep, Delilah cut his hair. And when the men came in to subdue Samson, they were able to succeed. And so while it is true that Samson was strong, and while it is absolutely true that his hair had never been cut, and while it is absolutely true that as long as he had his hair, the men could not subdue him, it is entirely false to believe that his strength was found in his hair. In fact, if we look down at verse number 20, it says this, talking about Delilah, it says, "Then she cried out, 'Samson, the Philistines have come to capture you.' When he woke up, he thought, 'I will do as before and shake myself free.' But he didn't realize the Lord had left him." And see, that was the source of his strength, the presence of God in his life. And God was with him as long as Samson walked in obedience, because the Lord had told Samson's parents, even before Samson was born, that a razor should not come upon his head. And as long as Samson walked in obedience to that, and walked in obedience unto God, he walked in strength. But when he disobeyed, it wasn't his hair that left him. It was God who had left him. And with the departure of the Lord, departed his strength. And so it is for us today. Many times when we need strength, we think we can find it in other things. Your strength is not in your prayer. It's in your obedience to what God reveals to you in prayer. Your strength is not in your reading or in your devotional time or in your daily disciplines. It's whether or not you obey God and listen to God, what He tells you during those times. Your strength is not found in your prayer service or your church service or in the position that you hold in your ministry. Your strength is found in your obedience. So today, if you need strength, ask God to reveal unto you if there is any place in your life where you are missing it, if there's any place in your life where you are failing to do something that God has already told you to do. And you will find, as He reveals those things unto you, as you walk in them and correct them, that your strength will return unto you. Because in your obedience lies your strength. Because when you obey God, you're walking with God. And when He is with you, you have all the strength that you need. God bless you. Until next time, be encouraged and know that Jesus loves you and His love never fails. No one loves. For sure, there is no